Good morning, everyone. We are starting today off in true build fashion, heading to Lowe's, because I realized last night not only did I not have that fiberglass mat that my mom did get me, but I'm missing the hardener, the thing that activates the fiberglass resin to make it hard and stiff like I need it to be. So I am on my way to Lowe's right now. Sorry, this is a very bumpy road, and I'm gonna grab that, probably grab a coffee, and then get back to the build. All right, activator secured, and then I also went and grabbed some new paint colors because even though I'm so far away from painting the interior, I can't help but think forward and get excited about what it's eventually going to look like. And I already know that I want to have more of an accent color because there's going to be a lot of wood tones, some silver from the metal, the stainless steel appliances that I'm using. I wanted to have some color in there, which is not something that I've really done in my past builds. So the two samples are drying right now, but I'll give you guys a sneak peek at what they might be. There are two other colors that I already have at home that I was liking but not absolutely in love with, so that's why I picked up these two. All right, so here are the two colors. This one is Duke Gray, and then this one up here is something sage, more of a green tone. I really like both of them, but I will say they're definitely more similar than I thought they were going to be. I think they're gonna dry a little bit different, but we'll see if I end up choosing either of them in the future. It's still pretty dewy out, and so I think before we head home, I'm gonna go grab a coffee, my second coffee of the day, to try to power through this morning, because this afternoon I'm really hoping, if at all possible, to take off with Tara to go camping on the coast. I know that we're in a rush to go get this camper done, but I'm really trying to have some balance in my life. And if these two projects are done, I'm just waiting for the windows, and otherwise the camper is effectively sealed. And so I don't need to be in such a rush that I stop completely living my life. But that's the goal for today. Get back, hope everything is dry, and then so long as it is, let's start installing this stuff and get ready to go camping. All right, so I'm back home and ready to start the install of the new fiberglass mat. First thing I'm gonna do is just sand around the edges to rough up the surface and try to get down to more of that bare fiberglass so we can make a really great contact patch. Then I'm gonna take some acetone, wipe it down, clean off any debris, and let it dry completely before I mix my fiberglass resin hardener and apply the mat. So let's head up to the roof. So the fiberglass patch is mostly done. It needs to set up for at least 2 hours, so it kind of looks pretty goopy and unfinished right now. Later tonight, I'm gonna go in with some more sandpaper and make sure all of the edges are pretty even, make it look a little bit nicer, and then hopefully in the future, I'll be able to find a gel coat that I can put on top just to try to match the color a little bit better so I don't have this like amber tinted patch anymore. But all in all, I'm actually really excited with how that came out. I used the entire package of fiberglass mat. Now, even though it won't be structurally sound to like put all my body weight on, it should be waterproof and hold up and then
then add to the structure of the camper as well, as opposed to just having a big gaping hole up there. Which, speaking of, I just got some really exciting news. My two bunk windows are coming tomorrow, which means I'm not going camping after all. So for the rest of the afternoon, I'm going to install my hatch, which, as you guys saw in yesterday's video, needs to be widened. The hole needs to be cut a little bit bigger to accommodate this new hatch that I purchased. And then I'm gonna prep everything for the window install tomorrow and the caulk removal, so that way I can make sure the camper is as watertight as possible before the rain comes on Thursday. So let's go head up to the roof to mark out where I need to cut for this hatch to be installed.
Cutting holes in your roof is one of those things where it's actually fast to go slow. Making sure that I did this right the first time, or at least didn't cut the hole too wide the first time, ensured that I wasn't going to have to create a fiberglass patch up front as well. So even though this took like an hour, I'm really glad it was too tight to begin instead of too big to have to fix. Okay, I'm just gonna see if this fits. Cross our fingers that it does. Is it still too tight? Oh, okay. So I think it's just too tight up in the front because this side's setting in really nicely. So I'm just gonna widen that front part a bit and it should slide right in. Let's try this again. All right, let's see. This is still really tight. Nice. It's definitely tight, but it fits. I'm gonna go ahead and pull this back down, clean everything up around it. So I'm gonna use acetone again just to get any residue off. Add some butyl tape to the underside and then get ready to screw this down.
While I'm applying the butyl tape, a few of you were very kindly very concerned that I was not butyl taping or sealing, applying like an exterior caulk to these windows. So I did respond to most of those comments, I think, but just in case you are also concerned, these windows, they actually specify to not put any sealant, any caulking on them because they already come with a really aggressive weather strip. So just wanted to seat any of those concerns. I am applying it to this because obviously this does not have a weather gasket on it, so it definitely needs it.
Thank you. Okay. Hatch is in and I'm gonna be honest, I'm getting really tired. So I think I'm gonna call it a day here, just clean everything up and then start with the fiberglass sanding tomorrow. So I'll see you guys then. I hope you've had a wonderful day. Thank you so much for being here. Bye.